Will 1 year be enough to get a permanent residency approved in Canada? We're about to find out in this video. Hi guys, my name is Evan. If it's your first time stopping over here, thanks so much for clicking on this video. I hope you subscribe before you leave. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about this very popular question that I've gotten a lot. Will 1 year program be enough for me to get my permanent residency approved in Canada? Is it risky? Yes, it is risky. I'm just going to say it right here, right now, before I even get into the video. It's very risky, but if you have the mind, if you have the mind and you're well prepared, you will definitely get through it. To be honest, I did a 1 year program here in Canada and that was how I was able to get the PR approved. So I'm just going to tell you guys a bit of my story and also give you guys some tips. If you're like, no, you're not really a school person, you don't really want to have to go for a 2 year program, go for a 3 year program, go for a 16 month program, you just want to come here, do a 1 year program and be able to get your PR approved, I'm going to tell you how I did that and some tips that can help you with yours. I've done a whole video on how I moved from Nigeria to Canada. I've done how I applied for my study permit. So I'm going to link those videos up here. I think they're probably here. I'm going to link those videos up here so you go watch them. I'm not going to go too much in detail of the whole process of coming in here. When I knew, okay, I'm going to come to Canada, I looked for a program that matched the job that I was doing at that time. I didn't want to come here and do a whole nother program that I'll just get lost, because to be honest, education here and back in Nigeria, it's different. And if you're here, you know it's not the easiest. At least know what you're getting yourself into. You don't want to leave BSc, for example, and come in here, do a master's or postgraduate program and you're struggling. Like, it's never going to make sense. At least do something that, you know, you're used to, something that you know quite a little bit about, something that even if you don't know about, it's really something you're interested in, something that you love and passionate about. It will really help you get through the whole education process. So that's what I did. I found a program that fits the job that I was doing. So at least I had an idea of what the program was about. I had some skills, a little bit of skills on that. And the program was 8 months in Canada. And typically 8 months is like 1 year here. Did that, I got in. I talked about the work permit process here in Canada. I'll link that video up here as well so you can go and watch it. But essentially, if you do a 1 year program or 8 months to 1 year program, you'd only get a 1 year postgraduate work permit. So the postgraduate work permit allows you get a full-time job, work full-time after your program here in Canada. You have to apply for it, but most definitely you get it, especially if you didn't like default, like work more than the hours allocated to you. Because when you're in school, you can only work 20 hours. And after school, like maybe when school is on the holiday, you can then work 40 hours. But I think right now there's a law, they set up a law or something that allows you work, you know, 40 hours, you know, more than 20 hours basically while you're in school. So that's good, you make more money. But literally at that time, it's only 20 hours as a student, except the school's on holiday, then you can work 40 hours. You do a 1 year program, they're going to give you a 1 year postgraduate work permit. If you do a 2 year program and above, they're going to give you a 3 year postgraduate work permit. And the thing about the postgraduate work permit, which I talked about in that video, is you can only apply for it once in a lifetime. So if you come here and you want to do a 1 year program or 8 months program, you do the program and you want to do another program after, just so you can qualify for the 3 year program, do not apply for the postgraduate work permit. As soon as your program is about to finish, apply for the next program, either in the same school or in another school, as the spirit leads. Apply for a second program, get the admission, pay the fees, you know, renew or extend your study permit, and then submit that so they'll extend your study permit for you so you can continue the second program. So only after that you can then apply for the postgraduate work permit, right? If you're doing a 1 year program and you're sure that you do not want to apply for another program, after that you can now apply for the postgraduate work permit. So basically, only apply for the postgraduate work permit when you're sure you do not want to go for another program. They'll only give you that one time. They're not going to give you that twice. They're not going to extend that for you. Nothing. The only reason why they may extend it is maybe your passport was already expiring and they didn't give you the full period. It's not even really extending. They're just giving you the remaining years that you qualify for. When I started my program here, I applied for WES. So WES is World Education Services, I think, something like that. So that's basically just to review your qualification and accredit whatever education or credential that you have where you're coming from. I already had a BSc before I came here. Like, they were just evaluating my BSc and just to see if it matches the BSc here in Canada. That is valid for 5 years, if I'm not mistaken. While I was doing my program here, me, I'm always ready. Let me tell you, if you want to embark on this journey with me, you want to do a 1 year program and get qualified, you have to be ready and stay ready. You have to be ready and stay ready. You can't be looking for one document. You can't be saying, oh, you can't procrastinate. You have to be sharp. You have to be on time. You have to know what's going on in the news. IRCC portal was my best friend. Like, if you want to do this, you have to be sharp. When I was doing my program here, I applied for the West and that got sorted. My school had sorted everything out and stuff like that. If you guys want me to do a detailed video on the whole Express Entry program, how you can apply for PR and all of that, let me know down below and I got you. I'll do it. So I got the West. The West and the English test, those are two main things that you need to get in the pool. Now, for the pool, think of it as like an actual pool, and there's a draw that happens every 2 weeks based on different programs. If you qualify based on the draw that it calls, so for example, let's say they call 490. If your number is from 490 and above, you get invited to apply. So that's just how it works, right? For you to get in the pool, you must have done your West and you must have done your English test. Make sure it's West Canada, because there's West United States. Don't do the wrong thing. And make sure the West you do is West General. General is for immigration. West Academic is for school. So don't do West Academic, because it's kind of different. If you're doing this for Express Entry, make sure you're choosing West Canada General. The next thing is the English test, right? You can do them simultaneously. You don't have to wait. But because I was in school, then I didn't want to get distracted. So immediately I was done with my school. Like 2 days after, or the next day, I did my English test because I already booked it at that time. So I did my English test, and for English test, you can either do IELTS or CELPIP. IELTS or CELPIP. I did CELPIP. CELPIP is cheaper. Was cheaper at that time. I don't know how much it is now, but it was cheaper at that time, and it's just easier for me to do. It wasn't as hard as IELTS, in my own opinion, because since Nigeria, I've been studying IELTS. So when I started studying CELPIP, I was like, it's not bad. And I actually started studying like maybe 4 days or 5 days before I took the test. I don't recommend, but I was doing final exams. I was so busy. And I told you, I did a video on my CELPIP exam and all of that. I'll link that video up here for you guys to watch it. I basically just watched their YouTube channel from morning till night. I'm just listening as I was doing stuff. So that helped me with the writing, reading, blah, blah, blah. So I talked about all of that in that video. So check it out. So once I got my West and my English test, bear in mind that I was already working in Nigeria before I came here. So I had 2 years and some months work experience, right? So I wasn't coming here straight from school. So if you're doing a 1 year program, I would advise that you do that only if you have work experience from where you're coming from, whatever country you're coming from. If you do not have any work experience from wherever you're coming from, maybe, just maybe, at least if you don't want to do 2 years, just do a 16 months program or 2 years, just because it's extra risky. So I already had 2 years work experience, and immediately my English test came out, I opened my CIC portal, filled out some questionnaires, and I had to put my West reference number. They'll give you that once they accredit your credential. I put my West reference number, and I had to put my English test scores. Make sure you get very high in that scores, because it will help jump your scores. There's some things that you cannot control, right? You can't control your age. You can't control if you're single or married, but at least you can control your English test. Just study and make sure you get very high scores, because that will like increase your CRS scores, basically. I did that, and my first score was like 479, which was really good. And I only qualified for Federal Skilled Worker Program at that time. I didn't have a job yet. I got a job months after, like 2-3 months after. But at that time, they were not doing any drills. Like, when I tell you, they were not doing any freaking drills. Oh my god, I was thinking about myself, because then I already had my postgraduate work permit. I applied for my postgraduate work permit after I submitted to be in the pool, but there was no draws, right? I got my postgraduate work permit approved, so now I transitioned from student to worker. And my postgraduate work permit was for 1 year, literally. I think about 4 or 5 months before my postgraduate work permit would expire, I got a provincial nomination from Ontario. That's what I got. Immediately, I said yes. Of course, you have to pay a fee. It's not free. They're expressing their interest in your application. When you accept, you go to their Ontario profile. It's going to be the same with any other province. You go to their website, create an account, sign up, fill out questions, apply. It's going to be like the IRCC. I think you have to upload documents and select some answers, some options, and all of that. And then you pay an amount and you submit. So that submission I did, this was like in February of the following year. By the time I did that submission, it took them about 2-3 months for them to approve. They approved and then invited me to apply. And that's when, with the provincial nomination, you get extra 600 points to your score. So that just increases your chances of being called. Because all through the time, they were not calling any draws. They were only calling provincial nomination program routes for the application. So I accepted that. I submitted that. That's after they approved me. I now submitted to IRCC. ICC invited me. I submitted my application to them in July, and then at that July they now had started calling draws from all other express entry routes, which if I did not accept the Ontario one, I would have still qualified, but that would leave me with only 1 month because my work permit was expiring in August, and they started calling back the draws in July. So I submitted my application in July for the IRCC and got approved like 3 months after or 2 months after, I don't remember. So that was my whole process. Let me tell you, when it was closer to that August, before, this was even before I got the Ontario nomination, I was sleeping well at night. I was praying. So if you're going to embark on this journey, just know you might have some sleepless nights. You might have sometimes you're just like, God, please, like, God, I beg. You're going to think about it. So just make sure you have the mind, make sure you're ready, because their rules here can change at any time. You want to make sure that you're always prepared. There was a time, I think in 2020, or was it early 2021, the draw, they called 75, which was literally everybody in the pool. So if you were even procrastinating, oh, I don't want to join now, I want to join next month, you'd have missed that opportunity. So the rules here change a lot. So I mean, you have to stay ready, get ready, stay ready. Be prepared, have all your documents ready. Immediately Ontario reached out to me. Before the end of that week, I had submitted everything, because I had everything ready. Like, I had everything that I needed ready. My friends used to make fun of me, like, I should just open visa consulting company to Canada. But I had everything I needed ready. The same thing with IRCC. Once they invited me to apply, that was even better, because most of what I needed to submit, I'd submitted to Ontario. And of course, you have to make sure they match whatever you're telling Ontario. You have to say the same thing to IRCC because the application is linked. So I just submitted everything with Canada. I had everything ready and I submitted. So now let me tell you some tips that will be very helpful for you if you want to just do 1 year program and apply for PR. And the reason why I didn't want to do another program is it's too expensive. I didn't have the money. Plus, there was no other program that interested me. I didn't want to go into class and be suffering to pass a test or get to understand what they're saying. So I didn't want to waste money. I didn't want to waste my time. I didn't want to stress my brain. Literally, first tip I'll give is, like I said, you have to be smart, you have to be fast, you have to have all your documents, you have to be ready. Like, nobody should be telling you when I'm going to apply. Nobody should be bugging you. You should know what you're doing. Of course, I'm saying be smart and be fast, but of course it cannot be done by the grace of God. Like, you know, put God, keep God involved, pray about it, like, let God help you through it. Because even if you have all the documents, what if they don't call you? You're not going to go and arrest them. You cannot go and hold their neck. So of course, put God first and just let him help you and grant you the grace that you need to get through this process. But also, you yourself have to do your work and, you know, be fast, be smart, and know what you need, have what you need ready. Now, I mentioned this as well, it's best if you have some form of work experience, you know, valid at that time. Even if it's 1 year work experience and stuff, because if you do the Canadian experience class, you have to work a full 1 year in Canada before you qualify for that. I already qualified for the Federal School Worker Program because I had 2 years work experience prior to coming to Canada. Now, when they started the draws, I qualified for all three because I had the provincial, I had the federal skilled worker, and then I had the Canadian experience class because I had already worked up to 1 year. But then I was already in the process of, my application was already in progress. It's really risky if you don't have any experience and you have to rely on getting 1 full year here, because they're only going to give you 1 year postgraduate work permit if you do a 1 year program, if that makes sense. So if you're doing that, either you have job experience prior to coming into Canada, because that'll be the best bet for you. Take your English test very early and do your worst, like, sort out those two things very early, because those are the two requirements, main requirements to get into the pool. So have that early. Just tell people IELTS. I always recommend tell people to everyone. You might do IELTS if you want. Tell people is easier for me. And also aim at a high score, because it can really help you increase your chances very high. So study hard. Don't say it's just English. Just make sure you know what you're doing as well. Now, immediately you're done with your program in school, create your CRS profile and submit. That will also help you. It will add some additional scores to your CRS profile because you studied here in Canada. But just immediately you're done, you have your WES and you have your English test, get into the pool. When you're in school, try and save some money, especially if you're working. save some money for your proof of funds, just setting some money aside for a proof of funds is going to be very helpful for you, because without proof of funds you cannot submit the application, or even if you submit they will probably reject you. Else, I'll say start your job search very early, especially for a full-time job. Once you know you're leaning towards the end of your semester, your final semester, start looking for a job. If you're already working somewhere very good that can work for your profile in school, talk to them about transitioning into from part-time to full-time roles as well. So just start searching for a job immediately, just so you have a job on hand, you're settled. And another thing is, if you do have a job, when you apply for PR, you don't have to show like the full proof of funds. If you show a letter of employment and pay stubs, you don't have to show. So it's also a way for you to save on saving aside money, if that makes sense. So getting a job will be very essential for you. The main thing is you just have to act very fast as well. Another thing to consider is the province that you're in, right? So there's some provinces like, you know, I think Alberta, some other provinces, Saskatchewan. As long as you school there, it's easier for you to get PR. For Ontario, the Shakara is much basically but there's the master's program route in Ontario, as I think other provinces as well. So basically, if you schooled here doing a master's program in Ontario, you can apply using that route. That's another route that they can use for the provincial, I think, to sponsor you, if I'm not mistaken. So know the province that you're in, know the PR pathways, just do everything fast and on time, and put God involved as well. I did the 1-year program because that's what I wanted to do. I didn't want to do another program. I didn't want to waste money. I didn't want to stress my brain. And God really helped me get through it, to be honest with you. It is really risky. Just set your mind to it. Do what you have to do fast and just hope for the best. So that's all I wanted to say today. I've said some things here that could have been confusing, but I can do an express entry here type of video showing you all these things, like, because there are three different pathways. There's the provincial, there's the federal skilled worker program, and there's federal skilled trades. I don't think you worry about the trades, just know basically provincial nomination, federal skilled trades, and Canadian experience class. So those are the three major ones that you want to look out for. Federal skilled trades as well, that one, they definitely require work experience, you to have work experience. Canadian experience class, you don't have to have work experience, you just have to have worked in Canada for up to 1 year. So that's it on this video. Let me know if you have any questions as well, any other comments to help anybody. If you've been here as well, what was your experience like? My one was not easy, but it was worth it. And thank you for helping me. But anyway, that's all I want to say in this video today. I hope you guys learned a thing or two from this video. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.